Good morning, dear children. How are you all? Fine? Safe? Okay. So, today we can start our fifth chapter, that is networking. Okay. So, it is not a practical session. You will have one word question and answers a lot from this chapter. Okay. Because it is related to networking and it is theory. Okay. So, here you can see that a story. What is that? What is the character in that story? Yes, Vibin. So, Vibin had gone to the hospital with his mother for taking the x-ray. Okay, x-ray of the leg. So, they are waiting for getting the result or getting that x-ray. But they didn't get that. They are meeting or they are consulting the doctor. At that time, Vibin had asked his doubt. Doctor, I didn't get the x-ray of the leg. Why it is so? At that time, the doctor is showing their x-ray in his computer. Okay, so the x-ray room is there and the doctor's room is here. Then how the x-ray or how that file came into the doctor's computer? Exactly. The both of that computers were connected together, right? So, dear children, you have to know that we can transfer or exchange the informations, that is data, from one computer to another computer if that computers are in the network or that computers are interconnected. Okay, so we are going to study the relations of computer networks in this chapter. Okay. Dear children, open your textbook, page number 59. Here, figure 5.1 is the illustration of a computer network. See, how many computers are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, 9 computers are here. And each of these computers are connected to the hub or switch. See, the first computer is connected to the hub. Second computer, third computer, fourth, and all the 9 computers are connected to the hub or switch. Okay. Also, it is having the hub or switch is connected to the modem. Modem is we will get the internet facility. Okay, Wi-Fi connection. So, all the 9 computers will get connected to the internet also. Okay. So, one computer is connected to scanner, another to printer, and the first computer is having the web camera. Okay. So, what is the specialty if these computers are interconnected? If this fourth computer is only having the facility to take the printout? No. The first computer or the second computer or all the other 8 computers is having the facility to take the printout. Why? Because these computers are interconnected. Okay. So, here are some questions that how many computers are interconnected in this network? How many computers are there? Yes, 9 computers. Which are the other devices connected to the computer? Can you list out that? First one is printer, then scanner, then web camera, modem, then hub or switch. Okay, so you have to fill these blanks. Next, you know that there are some devices that are required for connecting the networks or connecting the computers. Which are the devices? We need a cable for connecting all the computers, right? Then these cables must be connected to the computer. There is a port in the just behind of the computer. Did you see that? Okay. So we have to connect that cables to that port with the help of connectors. So two things are there. First one is cable, second one is connectors. And what is the third one? Yes. We need an instrument to control the exchange of information between the computers. What is that? Control the exchange of information between the computers in a network. Okay. So, two instruments we can study in this chapter, that is hub and switch. Okay, so let us examine what are the devices that is needed to connect the networks. Okay, so let us examine each of them in detail. Okay. Activity 5.2, examining the devices. Dear children, we studied now that there are three devices required for computer networking. First one is cables. So here you can see UTP cables. What do you mean by UTP? Unshielded twisted pair. So in the image you can see that the twisted pair. See, this is the UTP cable that is twisted together. Okay, so we can say that the cables which connect the computers in a network, that is called a UTP cable or unshielded twisted pair cable. Okay, so by observing this image, can you say any three features of this image? Yes, here you can see four wires, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 4 wires are there, but these 4 wires are arranged in 4 pairs, right? 1 pair, 2nd pair, 3rd pair and 4th pair. Okay, so 8 wires are there, they are arranged in 4 pairs. Then can you see any other feature? Is it colorful? Yes. How many colors are there? Yes, here we can see green color and it is paired with a white green color. Then brown color, white brown color, orange, white orange, blue, white blue. So we can say that there are 8 wires, they are arranged in 4 pairs and it is having 8 colors: orange, white orange, green, white green, blue, white blue, brown, white brown. Okay, so these are all about UTP cables. See, this is the UTP cable. Okay, now dear children, our second device that is required for computer networking is that we need a connector to join this cable with this computer. Okay, can you see a connector? Okay, so that is our second device, connector. Here is the connector, that is RJ45 connector. R is for registered, J is for jack. So registered jack connector or RJ45 connector. Okay, this is the image for RJ45 connector. You know that RJ45 connector will help us to connect the UTP cable with the computer. Okay. Here you can see another connector, that is RJ11 connector. What is the difference between RJ45 and RJ11 connector? You already know that RJ45 connector will connect the UTP cable with the computer port, right? But RJ11 connector connect the modem with the telephone network. Okay, so don't get confused with the two connectors. RJ11 connector connects modem with the computer networks and RJ45 connector connects UTP cable to a computer. Okay, so dear children, we have to connect the cable and connector, that is UTP cable and RJ45 connector. How can we connect that? Yes, with the help of a tool, and the name of that tool is crimping tool. Okay, this is the image for crimping tool. Okay, so RJ45 connectors are attached to the end of network cables using a tool that is called a crimping tool. Okay, we cannot connect this tool with any other ways, because here we can see white orange. This white orange is the wire that is in the
UTP cable. This white orange is to be inserted in the space provided for that color. Okay, it cannot be inserted in any other spaces. This is the connector. So this wire must be inserted in the space provided for that inside the connector. This orange color must be inserted in the space for that. White green color must be provided inside the connector, which provides the space for white green. Likewise, all the colors have to be, or all the wires have to be passed inside the connector in a particular manner, and it will be fixed using the crimping tool, that is crimping network cables. Okay, did you understood this? The UTP cable and the connector, RJ45 connector, can be connected with the help of crimping tool. The wires in the UTP cable are passed inside the connector in a particular manner, and it can be fixed with the help of the crimping tool. Okay. So, next one is hub. We studied that if there are more than two computers, then an instrument is required to control the exchange of data. Okay, so controlling the exchange of data, we need an instrument. Here you can see two instruments. First one is hub and second one is switch. So what is the difference between hub and switch? Let us see that. Here is the image for hub. It will connect all the computers directly to the hub. Okay, here you can see the ports. How many ports are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 ports are here, which means that 8 computers can be connected to this port. Okay, so there are lot of hubs that are available, but it is based on the number of computers that to be networked or connected. If you want to connect 16 computers, then this hub is not enough, because here it is only 8 ports. Okay, so we need a hub with 16 ports. Okay, so hubs are available based on the number of computers to be networked. Okay, so what do you mean by hub? It is an instrument which connects all the computers directly. Okay, so we can pass the information, or we can send any document or file. It may be an image, then it may be an audio or video, anything it is, we can exchange the information from one computer to all other computers that are interconnected. Okay, so here arises the problem with the hub. For example, there are 10 computers in a network. Okay, so one computer is having the information. A person has stored the information in one computer, and that information want to be passed to all other 9 computers with the help of a hub. Okay, so it means that the hub will transfer the copies of information to all the computers in the network. So it is not a problem if it is having only 10 or 20 computers. But can you imagine if there are 100 or more than 100 computers? Is it possible? It is possible, but the network will become congested, which means it will having the traffic. The network is having traffic problem, which means that the information or the document is sending to these 100 computers, there will be a traffic in the network. That means the network will become congested. Okay, so we have to overcome this problem. How? With the help of a switch. How can we overcome? or how can we use the switch? Yes, the switch will send the data or the document only to the particular computer to which it should be sent. Okay, so there are 100 computers and a document is saved in one computer. If we are using the hub, it will send to all other 99 computers and it will occur or it will result in the traffic. But if we are using a switch, then it will send that document only to the particular computers. Okay, so there will not be any problem. There will not be the traffic issues. Okay, the congestion in the network is significantly reduced. Is it clear? So did you got the idea about hub and switch? So which one is better, hub or switch? If you need to transfer the files to all the computers, then hub is better, but there arises the congestion. Okay, the network will be congested. So we can say that switch is better than hub. Okay. So dear children, you know that files can be easily exchanged through networks. Can we exchange only the files? Then what all devices we can exchange through the networks? Yes, here is the list of that. We can share the printer. If any of the computer, any one computer is connected with the printer, then we can give the instruction to print from other computers if it is networked. Did you got the idea? There is only one printer in our computer lab and there are 10 computers in the lab. Okay, imagine that there are 10 computers and only one printer. So we can give the instruction to print from all the 10 computers to this single printer if it is connected. Okay, if it is in the network. Likewise, we can share the internet. Then next one is we can share the camera. So right here we can share the camera, scanner, etc. Okay. So dear children, did you got the idea about the three devices that is required for computer networking? Yes, first one is cables, that is UTP cables, that is having 8 wires arranged in 4 pairs and 8 colors. Then connectors, that is RJ45 connectors, registered JAC45 connectors will connect to the computer and the UTP cable. Then RJ11 connector will connect to the modem with the telephone network, and then RJ45 connector and the UTP cable can be connected with the help of the crimping tool. Then the instrument, there are two instruments, hub and switch, which is required to control the exchange of data between the computers. Okay, hub is different and switch is different, but their function is same. What is their function? To control the exchange of information. Okay, so hub is having a problem, that is it will transfer the copies of information to all the computers in the network and the network will become congested. But a switch sends the data only to the particular computer to which it should be sent. So the congestion in the network will reduce. Okay, so dear children, these are all about today's topic. So this is the theory portion. You have to write one word question and answers and you have to send it to my WhatsApp number. Okay, if you are having any doubts, you can contact me. Thank you.